So, and that's what happened. The Most High gave Adam a saving plan. When he told Eve, your seed will crush the head of the serpent, and the serpent will bruise his heel. Now, getting back to the evil in this world, this has enraged Satan. Satan is enraged because we have been given a saving plan and he didn't. And he is enraged at the Most High for that. Now keep in mind, the Most High planned all this out. And he even put the rage in Satan. So Satan in his rage hates the Most High with such a passion, and he hates everything the Most High created, including us. So, could the Most High just totally get rid of Satan right now? And then all the evil would be gone, wouldn't it? Yeah. In fact, one day Satan will be gotten rid of. Forever. But as it stands right now, his time is not yet, because Satan is just a tool for all the people on the earth to learn that the Most High is omnipotent, all powerful, all authority. And so, since how mankind fell in the garden and participated in the sin, right? Now, what did the Most High tell him what would happen if he did that, if he participated in eating that fruit? Told him, dying you shall die. In other words, what? Hard times are coming, both in this life and in the next. Nothing but death. So, is the Most High a liar? Or is the Most High omnipotent, all powerful? That's being described as all fair and all loving. And so he doesn't go back on his word. He's not a liar that he should lie. He told Adam, if you eat that fruit, nothing but death. Is going to be the consequence. And so how does all this death come about? Well, how does all this evil we see in the world come about? Is it because the Most High isn't willing to prevent it, or not able to prevent it? Or is it because the Most High knows that it has to be, because it's the only way for us to know the whole story of what happened in heaven when Satan tried to be like the Most High and committed the sin. Otherwise, if things were just fine and dandy, and there is no death, if there is no expectation of death and punishment, then how would we ever come to the conclusion through a real life experience? Because that's how things are really known in life, isn't it? When we experience things, then we start to see, oh, I experienced it. Now I understand. Now I see. Whereas before, I was just going on my way, and then things happened. And then after they happened, I said, So, while we're on this earth, we are supposed to come to that place of, oh, I see. And if there, and so the experience has to be there so that we can go, oh. Satan committed the sin. He tricked Eve into committing the sin. Adam willfully participated in the sin. Now, the Most High is not a liar that he should lie. Now, death has entered over their life. So the Most High is keeping his word. He told them, dying you shall die. That's what the original Hebrew says. There's two deaths. Physical death and eternal death. And that also describes all the hard times. Everything that we can think of that can go wrong on this earth, that we use one word to describe it all. Evil. And so here we have Satan. He pulled a trick. His number one trick. What was his trick? To get Eve to think that she could be like the Most High. The very thing that got him kicked out has now gotten her kicked out. And Adam. And so now they've inherited death. And And now they've inherited the propensity to be deceived and to be mind controlled and seeing how Satan was the one that tricked them into death. Now the same death that is holding Satan is also holding them. And Satan is allowed to run rampant on this earth, and the Most High allows it. The Most High allows all this evil. But remember, the Most High does not is not the one who is causing the evil, although he's in control of it, and he uses Satan as his tool to bring evil into the earth. Right? The Most High is not evil. He just allows the evil that Satan brought forth. Although all the evil was written in the script even before Satan was created. Right? So in a way we could say the Most High, right, created evil. We could say that in a way, right? Because nothing that's created is created unless the Most High creates it. So here we have the Most High creating evil and using Satan as his tool. But it was for a purpose. Because this is what I believe. I believe this is the only way it could be. And the best way it could be. So that we as people could understand through our experience amongst all this evil. To understand why it is, how it was created, where it comes from, who's perpetrating it. Because it's all part of the plan. It's all part of the story to be remembered. Everything that's happened, it's our history. and it's there to teach us